how quickly and quietly you can find yourself all alone.
Tark's got a ground for
fight him, Tark!
Let's kill him!
Someone needs to learn how to stretch things out. Every Orc Iron Slave bears my brand. Hot iron on seared flesh. Soon I will brand you as well and show all of Mordor I own you.
Kill that guy.
Not every author seeks to inspire. Some seek to instruct. So it is with Contrivances of Carpentry by Pelwyn of Lossenach. I spend many an hour tracing the wondrous diagrams within this tome. Instructions for building everything from hobby horses to windmills to catapults. I wonder sometimes who taught more apprentice carpenters, Pelwyn or his book.
As a lad, I was always... fascinated by woodwork. Turning boards into furniture, a home.
Talion the craftsman. That I'd have liked to see.
Come closer, Tark!
Gonna hear footsteps in a bit. And maybe a scream or two. Anyway, get ready!
Get it now!
What's the matter?
Afraid to join the party?
Not today!
Oh, finally! Look, legs! Fresh meat! I'll rip your heart out! Right, let's see what you got!
Petragitha.
The ability to scry, to see beyond the limit of ordinary vision, has always fascinated us. Those who claim to scry say pools of still water held in an antique bowl can foresee Mordor's many dangers, or reveal a glimpse of fair Gondor itself. But the bowl lacks the range or clarity of the Palantir, and I wonder whether it shows us anything beyond what we might wish to be true.
Could the old scribe sit a bowl?
Yes, and doing so was safer than using a Palantir, because the visions travel in only one direction.
A few boulders tossed about ought to get their war chief's attention.
Minas Ithil's bookshelves cannot compare to the great libraries of Minas Tirith, but they're still the biggest collection of knowledge for miles in any direction. As a girl, I thrilled at the wisdom gathered here. Everything from histories to poetry to cookbooks from a bygone age. This one, Tales of Farthest Umbar, was a childhood favorite.
I became a ranger, thought I'd see the entire world.
It is much the same everywhere. The ambitious striving against the dull. The orc strains his feeble mind plotting and planning. Let us make things simpler for him.
And now the hunt shall end.
Worse. Action!
Stronger than any witchery of yours! Prepare to die!
We're done talking! It's time to start killing!
Just a lump of dead meat, ready to be butchered.
Think of your... Nay, Celebrimbor, of the life you had.
There was a time when I thought of them every day. That was a long time ago.
Yeah!
Got to light the beacon!
Wretched swine! A good hit!
Bade invade Mordor. Phylas, the virtue of justice. Sauron had betrayed me and my people, and I was determined to punish him for it.
Thank you.
Scores have very. Let's get to it. Alone. Come on, let's flee this talk. Your head to true blood by the sharper shop. Think I'm new? You will no pain! And it's your fault!
Bring light.
I'm no right soldier. No, get ready.
Thank you.
Scared? I think not. You better not think I'm scared, because I'm not. I'm not!
Anymore! A worthy world! Ishmoz.
Where'd you go, Chuck? I'll try again. He felt dead. You won't get me that way.
And now the hunt shall end.
Thank you.
rules on my hunters, eh? I'll show our intruder who the real predator is!
Teeth the Caligon has
smashing
enough to chop your right in half.
I was at the siege of Mina Sea. They almost held us back.
Pain dealer! I see you're giving out pain. I want some. Make it hurt like you hurt all the others. No, make it even worse. I can take it. I want it. I need it. Punch me!
Down on
him! I've got you! Let him! I want pain!
They fancy themselves to be tamers of beasts.
Their beasts won't stop us from taking their fortress.
Up above!
We Gondorians are a seafaring people. Though our ships ply the coastlines and rivers, rarely venturing into the open sea. Yet it was not always so. Our ancestors, the Numenoreans, and their elven allies, sailed to other lands in ships like this model. Sailors even claim it's possible to sail so far into the ocean that land is too distant to see in any direction. Hard to imagine. So I suppose I'll have to see it for myself someday.
Did the elves truly and vessels such as these?
In the First Age, this would count among the most ordinary ships in our fleet.
My first drill instructor told me, trust in your training, not your armor. Even a finely wrought plate can buckle under a hard enough blow, but a skilled warrior can evade that blow so it never lands in the first place. Now Minas Ithil has buckled under. Some blows are impossible to evade, so we...
This armor is intended to be ceremonial, yet it seems sturdy enough.
As it should be. Gondor has little need for ceremony of late.
An impressive kill.
But it won't keep.
Those who live in Gondor's lowlands could easily forget how close to Mordor Minas Ithil was. Few of Gondor's people devote more than a moment's thought to its borders, or what lies beyond. For them, the threat of Mordor is distant indeed.
I've never seen a map of Gondor so detailed.
Yet look at how little your people know of other lands. Let our foes fortify with iron and stone. Let them summon scabrous serpents, feral beasts. It will avail them naught. Across the ages, none have an army that wields such weapons, such woe, such doom against the dark, benighted hordes who dare claim dominion over a Mordor soon bright.
Orcs fight each other endlessly to climb the higher peak.
Then we shall find the ones who rise to the top. They are who we want in our army.
Wait till you see the tricks I taught this one!
Tars.
You'll not dive on me, little sparrow! That was your best shot, eh? Well, now it's my turn. And I'll do you the courtesy of a fair warning. I reckon it's mealtime!
Yeah!
Mordor has no shortage of seasoned warriors.
From them, we will build our army. Nern is overrun with orcs, perfect for our purpose.
What became of Lothariel? The people? Queen Mom? It's she who first suggested an orc army.
This time will be different. We have the new ring.
I've had enough of your mouth, Bruce. So now I'm gonna kill you, for all these orcs to see.
Always said you were an optimist. Know what that is, mate? It's about sizing up a situation that's bloody impossible and saying, yeah, all right, I'll have a go. I'm exactly the same way.
I like him.
Tickle, maybe, but you're gonna need more than that to take me down.
Same thing, really. End results me ripping spines out, which I like to do anyway, so either way's a win.
A fine addition to our army.
Name's Bruce. From here on out, I will be your shadow. No one gets to you without my say-so.
Don't worry about my enemies. They will all follow eventually.
You want to plant your flag in Mordor, you'll need to do it deep. There's a fortress nearby. They say it's ruled by a two-headed troll big as a mountain. Deadly smart, which, well, because you'd have to be given the two heads. You take him down, you'll send a message to Sauron, and get yourself some nice new digs as part of the bargain.
I'm not going to do this alone.
Gather your troops.
Will do. Ooh, just make sure you let me pop his heads off, won't you?